that's one of the greatest things about powerlifting is that it's not only a competition against other lifters, it's really more of a competition against yourself. So there are a lot of times when you can go into a meet and possibly not even have any competition, but you're really there to try to break your own record or just basically improve on yourself. Since, you know, I've gotten to a point where I'm at the higher level for my weight class, there's really only a handful of guys that, you know, are close to me. So they're definitely, it's definitely a driving factor to have them there too. But as always, it's good to be able to compete against myself and my own records. I decided to move up from the 148-pound weight class because I broke the all-time total for the third time, and this time I broke it by over 100 pounds. That had a lot to do with it because I knew that I hopefully had at least secured that total for a while and that nobody would be breaking it. But it also had a lot to do with the fact that over the years I've gradually put on more and more muscle, which has made it increasingly more difficult for me to drop the weight that I need to get down to the 148-pound class. When I'm actually at the competition, I mentally focus and think about what I need to do. I visualize what the lift should look like, what it should feel like, and, you know, it's basically what I need to do to make everything correct. The equipment, or the gear as it's referred to, originally came about to a weight belt. It was to protect the lifter from getting injured. But then lifters, you know, found out that they actually were able to handle more weight with it.
Big air. Come on.
In the squat, the lifter needs to unrack the weight. The weight is sitting across their shoulders, they need to stand upright with it. They get the squat command from a head judge, and they have to drop to a point where the crease of their hip is below the top of their knee, and then stand completely upright with it and get a rack command. Deadlift is where the lifter grabs the bar from the ground and stands upright with it. There's only one command given by the judge, which is a down command when the lift is complete. The bench consists of laying on the bench, which is a more common lift. People are usually more familiar with it. Where they lay flat, bring the bar down until it's motionless on their chest. They get a press command from the head judge. Then they have to fully extend at arm's length. It needs to be one constant motion until the bar is locked evenly, and then they get a rack command. Rules involved, such as with the squat, not only do they need to go below parallel, but they need to make sure that there's no up or downward motion, which is also the same as with the bench, with the bar, same as with the deadlift. There are three judges in every meet. There's a head judge and two side judges, and they each have a red and white light. At the completion of each lift, they give either a white light, which denotes a good lift, or a red light, which denotes a bad lift. The lifter needs to get at least two white lights for the lift to be considered good.
Yeah. you give it up. Think about your life, you wouldn't give it up.
Last year, I was ranked number 2 in the 165s. My best lifts in that weight class are a 788 squat, a 600 bench, and a 628 deadlift. I guess at some point it's inevitable that my body is going to get to a point where my strength is not going to keep increasing, so I hope I get to my max before it's, you know, it's too late. I don't foresee stopping anytime soon, so as long as I can, my body will hold up, I plan to continue.
Your life, you wouldn't give it up. Think about your life, you wouldn't.